before we came.
So, we just danced in the capital of Ghana at a funeral, and they accepted us. There's not many cultures that would accept us dancing. They went wild. And I'm just feeling so great right now.
As this trip has gone on, it's not just, you know, about, it's about learning about culture, which is extremely important, but you learn about, I've learned a lot about myself, and like in my busy life, it's, what do I gotta do? You know, what's tomorrow? What appointment do I have? I have to call this person, and I never have time to sit and think about, wow. This in Ghana, you can take the time and sit like this, but in America, you just walk right over it.
like my mother live in her house, in the church, and at her work, but never sticks her neck outside in the community, never pays attention to what's going on in the rest of the world because she's locked herself in this safety zone where she doesn't want to know, but she's got her money and she's holding her money so tightly. And when God says to her in the end, why didn't you help anyone? What were you so afraid of? Why didn't you live? You know, she's so afraid of dying poor. And I see women in poverty with the biggest smiles on their face. So you shouldn't be afraid of being poor. You should be afraid of not being happy, of dying sad. You know, that's what life is about, is discovering happiness and living to be happy. The people of Africa have that figured out.
Just a little dot on a big continent anymore to me in a map, you know, like something you look at in a textbook or something. Now it's a place that I've been and I've looked into the people's eyes and I think about that, you know. I think about the friends that I made and what they're doing and, you know, I don't know. I'm thinking right now about somebody I gave a raincoat to who is a fisherman and thinking about maybe he's out on the ocean somewhere wearing that jacket, and that's cool, man, you know.
And I just think of people when they looked at you there. They truly wanted to know something about you, no matter who you were. And they understood that each person was different, but had something amazing to give to the world. And that was just an incredible feeling for me, to meet people and be able to share things that they took the time to listen to when I came from such a different background than they did. And I'll never forget that.
The warmth and see the ocean and like feel the warmth not only of the place but of the people, and all of the memories and all the experiences that I had were so different and they impacted me so differently, and it's something that I'll have forever and something that will change me forever, that changed me forever, and they're just things that I would never trade for anything.
Ghana, after having been there, I remember before I went wondering what it would be like to breathe the air there. And I can say now that it's really heavy. And Ghana itself is all about senses. I felt like I was so alive there. Every sense was alive there from the moment we stepped off the plane. The smells, the flavors, the food was unbelievable, and I miss it now. And the sounds, when people asked me, oh, how was your trip in Ghana? You know, what was it like there? Every single time, I haven't gotten better at it. Every single time, I have to stop and think, because such a flood of memories and impressions and ideas come to my mind that it's difficult to put into just even a few words. My general reaction to that is, oh, how much time do you have? Because I could talk a lot about
that. I think of the little kids that were always on the beach and that got sand in everybody's cameras, but it was great because we all got these priceless pictures of all these kids and got to meet so many wonderful people.
And a
experience something like Ghana is unbelievable. You know, you see another human being in a completely different set of circumstances, in a completely different lifestyle, brought up completely differently, different backgrounds, different everything. And to see how that person lives can completely change your life, you know? And I cannot explain that to you because you have to experience it for yourself.
Africa is a beautiful place for everybody in this planet to be able to visit, which is very important because sometimes when I hear some people saying Ghana, Africa, that women have been raped, or they think Ghana, Africa have so much HIV, saying bad things about Africa, it's not like that. People live there and people have a better life. Every year I try to organize study abroad program to take people to Ghana to be able to see the taste of Ghana, West Africa. So I want people, everybody who's gonna look at this, to make sure that look, Ghana, West Africa is not a bad place to people to visit. It's very good, it's touching. If you go there, I don't think that you wanted to come back.
For my love is like the